Here is a piece of breaking news. Maharashtra Mangrove Cell is going to acquire a drone to keep an eye on the mangrove killers, the people who dump debris, the land mafia, etc. across Mumbai Metropolitan region. Mr. Virendra Tiwari, the additional principal chief conservator of forests of the Mangrove Cell, himself has disclosed this during an online discussion at an event organized by the NatConnect Foundation on the occasion of the International Day of Biodiversity.
We have appointed one consultant, that is Ernst Young, to carry out survey for the location to install CCTV cameras. So basically, all the sensitive areas where we want to protect the mangrove are protected from dumping. So we have given a study to a company who will identify the specification of the cameras and where to be located. And of course, they would also tell us the approximate cost. So in future, we would like to at least start this type of monitoring also using technology, maybe drone also. We do plan to purchase a drone also.
As you are all aware, we have been complaining repeatedly against about this killing of mangroves across MMR, particularly in Uran, Kharghar, Ulwe, Vashi, and many other places across MMR.
And our hands are tied to the extent that we can act only whenever an area is a reserve forest or protected forest. Under Indian Forest Act, we cannot go beyond that. If an area is a private mangrove or it is on any government land which is not declared as forest, Indian Forest Act is not applicable. So there we have to take action under Environmental Protection Act, under which only four authorities of the state government are given that power. So one is Secretary Environment, the other is the Pollution Control Board, the third is collector, and fourth is the deputy collector. So other than these four authority, there is no other state authority is delegated with the power under Environmental Protection Act. And in this regard, Honorable Minister Environment has written a letter to MOEF Minister requesting that this power should be delegated to Forest Department.
BNH's Director, Dr. Vivash Pandav, has given the keynote address at this seminar, and he was very particular, very emphatic on one point, that the wetlands around Navi Mumbai Airport have to be conserved, have to be preserved. Otherwise, the birds which will be disturbed in from these areas can cause a disaster to the airport. Over to Dr. Vivash Pandav.
We have lovely mangrove forest. Problems are enormous. You go to the creek. Creek has lost all its characteristic only because of the sheer volume of pollution in those areas. But still, they are so full of life. Still, there are quite a bit of mangrove forest left that can be protected and that can be propagated, actually. The area can be preserved and we can add additional area, even if it is small. I mean, all of us know the real estate value in Bombay. 1 inch is very precious for us. So that's why I say 1 inch of protected or 1 inch of forested or green area is very, very precious to us. NHS is actually currently carrying out studies looking at the species richness, species diversity, especially from birds' point of view, as well as other marine life in this area. So I would say, I don't think BNHS intends to stop it completely, these projects, or BNHS can stop it. But the data, the volume of data that is being generated from these studies, I mean, we just have started 1.5 years, 2 years back. It's a long-term project that's going to take place. The amount of information that's going to be generated, it will be available in open forum. And we have to use this information and convince the policymakers that these are the critical areas. Please leave these areas aside.
And how CIDCO can develop Panjai wetland, being a low-lying area, being a flooded area, how they can demarcate entire area illegally with different sections from 16 to 28, and flooding is happening. This is flood control mechanism. Flood control mechanism area they have sold to Reliance. This is complete nonsense.